Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the National Music Museum on a Wednesday night. A great night for a concert. We thank you for being here. I'm Dwight, the director of the museum. This is a music department event, but it's also a wider collaborative event. And so I wanted to just give a quick welcome to you and also welcome our folks who are joining by the live stream tonight, because this is a very special event because we have some premier performers who are performing on some museum instruments tonight. And so this is the 1901 Mason and Hamlin Concert Grand CC piano that we got a few months ago. And in a minute, Arian will be talking about the string instruments that will be featured on tonight's program. I just wanted to welcome you, thank the music department and the College of Fine Arts and Drs. Sonja Kraus and Brooks Hafey, who will be performing in just a moment. And a special shout out tonight to the donor of our string instruments, so Mr. Ken Cancelosi, who is in Dallas, Texas, joining us on live stream. So Ken, thank you very much. Welcome again from your friends at the National Music Museum. All right, so the context of tonight's performance is a little bit different. You're going to get some museum, you're going to get some background and some history, and then you're going to get to hear three of the instruments in the Cancelosi collection, so you can compare for yourself three historical cellos as they will be performed on different pieces. And to start that off is going to be our string and keyboard curator, Arian Sheets, who's going to start your learning experience right now. Arian?
Thanks so much, everyone, thanks everybody so much for coming tonight. The Cancelosi Collection is really a unique program that we have that houses these historic instruments and bows in the museum, but allows them to be accessible to performers here on campus and guest artists. And Sonja Kraus has decided to dedicate her faculty recital to featuring all three of the Italian cellos in the collection. She's going to start off on the Chopin with the Gennaro Gagliano from 1735. This cello was made in Naples by, there were multiple members of the Gagliano family who were very prominent violin makers. And Gennaro was the second generation. He and his brother Niccolo were probably the most celebrated of the Gagliano family members. And this particular instrument is a Stradivari model of cello. So it's a type of design developed by Antonio Stradivari, but made in Naples. And the bow that she's going to be using with this cello was made by a contemporary American maker named Roger Zabinski. Roger Zabinski was based in Minneapolis, and unfortunately he passed away this week, but he was a dear friend to many of us in the field. So with that, we will start off with the Gennaro Gagliano 1735 and the Roger Zabinski bow from the 1990s.
For being here. I am not going to talk a lot because I don't think anybody's here to hear me talk. Plus, these instruments haven't been played in front of an audience in over a decade, and I feel like they deserve to sing for you. So we really hope you enjoy this evening. Thank you so much, Ken, for this wonderful donation, and to all the museum staff for making this possible, because it's like a dream come true. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
basically indefinitely. They'll be up on the website or whatever. We have concerts last about a year ago. Kevin Vicens, who played the Portuguese piano, and it's still up on the website.
Thank you.
Well, we're about ready to begin the second half, and you will hear two different cellos on this half. And you might ask, well, what do we get out of hearing three different instruments in a concert and three different bows? That's a really good question. I guess you'll have to listen for this. The Cancelosi collection was assembled by Robert Cancelosi, who was a professional cellist and scholar, and who was fascinated by the different sounds that you could get out of different instrument and bow combinations. And so he put together a group of instruments and bows that he felt worked particularly well for him. And there were many, many hours of him and his son exploring how much difference it made to try different instruments and different bows, and which bows worked well with which cellos, and vice versa. And so these are combinations. Some of the combinations you're hearing today are actually ones that Robert preferred as well. And some are combinations that we don't know if he preferred, that Sonja has picked. The next cello that you're going to hear is a instrument that's also in the Neapolitan school by the nephews of the previous maker. Giuseppe and Antonio Gagliano were the nephews of Gennaro Gagliano. This cello was made in 1776, and it is not a Strad model. It's a slightly different model, and the way we liken the sound is it's a bit more restrained and polite. The Gennaro is very bold and bossy and brilliant. And so they're really good for quite different things. And if you came to the last trio concert, you have heard this instrument before. And a combination that Sonja particularly likes is this instrument paired with a bow by a maker named Eugene Sartori. And Sartori was one of the most celebrated 19th and 20th century French bow makers. He has his roots in the French town of Mirecourt, which is particularly important to the violin and bow making industry in France. And this bow was probably made in the first quarter of the 20th century. So now you can enjoy a new combination of wine and cheese, I mean cellos and bows.
Thank you.
We have one final selection for you today, and you're going to hear quite a different sound out of this cello. This is an instrument from Cremona, from the same town as Stradivari and Amati worked. It's a Francesco Ruggeri from 1683. Francesco Ruggeri may have studied with Niccolo Amati, but he's particularly important when it comes to the cello because he's thought to be the first maker to make smaller sized cellos. If you look at our King cello here at the National Music Museum by Andrea Amati, that instrument was originally much larger. It was a bass violin as part of the violin band, perhaps 3-4 inches longer than you see it now, and it was cut down. What allowed Ruggeri to successfully make a smaller instrument were changes in string technology. At the time, musicians and makers were using natural gut strings made out of sheep gut. And when the technology was created to overwind the lower strings with metal, all of a sudden you could get a heavier string, which allowed you to make a slightly shorter string length, but the increased weight ensured that it wouldn't sound bad or not speak very well. So Ruggeri took advantage of this new technology and made more manageable sized instruments for the increasingly virtuosic and complex music written for bass instruments at that time. The bow that Sonja's going to use with this cello is by the English maker James Tubbs, and he was a very prolific and celebrated English maker, part of a whole family of bow makers, the Tubbs family. You might see that this is a theme, that in traditional instrument making, this kind of work tends to run in families. So one thing you might hear with this is just how rich the sound is. This is a particularly chocolatey cello, and I think it's fitting that it actually is the color of chocolate. So enjoy your after-dinner snack.
Thank you.
Thank you.